Sir, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, pray silence for the Right Worshipful the Lord Mayor of Liverpool, Councillor Ross Gladden.
Lord Lieutenant, my Sheriff, Honorary Consul, Reverend Sir, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to Liverpool Town Hall on this historic occasion. The presentation, you have to forgive my friend here, I'm going to try and do this in a French accent. Just bear with me. The Order National de la Légion d'Honneur of the Honorary Consul of France, in the room, Mr. Philippe Daniel, on behalf of the President of the Republic of France and its people. Is that okay? Yeah. You'd be surprised. The Legion of Honour, or in full the National Order of the Legion of Honour, is a French order which was established by Napoleon Bonaparte on the 19th of May, 1802. The order is the highest decoration in France. The city of Liverpool and the area has always had strong connections with the military. This has been acknowledged over the years by honouring many of our local regiments, with the highest honour that we can bestow is the freedom of the city. The city appreciates our armed forces and how important it is to acknowledge the risks that these brave men and women have made and still take every single day to ensure that our world is a much safer one. We owe all those who have served and still serve our country a huge debt of gratitude. It is, of course, very important that we remember those who did not return from conflict, and each year Liverpool pays its respects at the service of remembrance and dedication held at the cemetery on St. George's Hall, Passover. As Lord Mayor, it has been a great honour to attend so many military-related events during my year in office, and I am delighted to host today's ceremony. It is a fantastic gesture by the French government to acknowledge our brave men from this remarkable generation. And it gives me great pleasure to congratulate all the medical recipients that are here today. You truly deserve this highest honour. It is also my privilege to present two honorary citizens of honour at the City of Liverpool this afternoon. Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, it is now fitting that I now introduce the Rector of Liverpool, the Reverend Dr. Desmond, who will provide a prayer for those who did not return. Thank you.
If you are able, will you please stand? We remember with thanksgiving and sorrow those whose lives have been given and taken away in the conflict. Almighty and eternal God, from whose love in Christ we cannot be parted, either by death or life, hear our prayers and thanksgiving for fallen comrades and the fellowship and friendship of past service. Fulfill in those we remember the purpose of your love, and bring us all with them to your eternal joy, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Most holy God and Father, hear our prayers for all who strive for peace and all who fight for justice. Help us to today remember the cost of war to work for a better tomorrow. And as we commend to you lives lost in terror and conflict, bring us all in the end to the peace of your presence, through Christ our Lord. Please be seated.
Ladies and gentlemen, it is now my pleasure to introduce Lieutenant Colonel Sean McAvoy, who will provide the background on the Order National de la Légion d'Honneur.
The order is the highest decoration in France. French Revolution, all French orders of chivalry were abolished and replaced with weapons of honour. It was the wish of Napoleon Bonaparte, the first consul and de facto military dictator, to create a reward to commend civilians and soldiers, and from this wish was instituted the Legion d'Honneur, a body of men that was not an order of chivalry, but Napoleon believed France wanted a recognition of merit rather than the new system of nobility. The Legion, however, did use the organization of the old French orders of chivalry. Like the Ordre de Saint-Louis, the badges of the Legion also bear a resemblance to the Ordre de Saint-Louis, which also used the red ribbon. The Legion was loosely patterned after a Roman Legion with legionnaires, officers, commanders, regional cohorts, and a grand council. The order was the first order of merit. The orders of the monarchy were often limited to Roman Catholics, and all knights had to be noblemen. The military decorations were the perks of the officers. The Legion, however, was open to men of all ranks and professions. Only merit or bravery counted. The new legionnaire had to be sworn in to the Legion. The Grand Master appoints all members of the order on the advice of the government. The Grand Master's insignia is the grand collar of the Legion, worn only by the President of the Republic of France, who is Grand Master of the order. On the 70th anniversary of D-Day in June 2014, the French President announced that this distinction would be awarded to all British veterans who fought for the liberation of France during the Second World War. Veterans must have taken part in military operations in France between 1944 and 1945. Operation Neptune, the Normandy landings, with a landing operation on Tuesday, the 6th of June 1944, termed as D-Day. Of the Allied invasion of Normandy, in Operation Overlord during World War II, the largest seaborne invasion in history, the operation began liberation of German-occupied northwestern Europe from Nazi control and contributed to the Allied victory on the Western Front. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, it is now my privilege to read the individual citations, after which my recipient to come forward for the presentation of the Ordre National de la Région de l'Air by the Honorary French Consul, Mr. Philip Daniel.
Lord Mayor, Lord Lieutenant, High Sheriff, Reverend Sir, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen. It's a pleasure to be here this afternoon. It's an honour to be here representing the French nation to present the highest award to the Legion of Honour to the soldiers who are here today. I would like to offer my thanks for the hospitality that we received this afternoon at the Town Hall. This is the first time the Town Hall has met in this way, and it's a wonderful place to hold these ceremonies. Thank you very much. I would also like to say thank you to the Lord Lieutenant and the High Sheriff, who have also supported these ceremonies, not only in this room, but in other rooms in this Town Hall, and who also are part of a large number of men and women who perform these civic roles without complaint, with generosity, and in a manner which is always hospitable. I've done these ceremonies in Preston, Chorley, and in Wallasey, and on every occasion, I have always been so grateful for the support which they've shown. The most important thanks, I think, should go to thinking that they would be the first to say that they are accepting this award on behalf of all those people who took part in the D-Day landings in 1944. Not only those they came back with, but those they left behind. I feel that their effort contributed to political achievement at the end of the Second World War, which led to a period of relative peace and a period unlike for which for people like me, that I have not had to be conscripted, called up to war, I have to say thank you very much to those recipients for making that possible for me in my generation. Thank you very much. We'll start with the award ceremony.
Recipient this afternoon is Captain Timothy Joseph Fitzgerald, 3rd Battalion, the Irish Guards. Captain Tim Fitzgerald is now 91. When he enlisted into the Irish Guards to go toward the line about his age, the recruiting sergeant must have been from the mix and recognised him as a young man with potential and allowed him to enlist only because he was joining. Captain Fitzgerald saw action in Northern Europe during World War II. As a member of the Guards Armoured Division, he came ashore at Sword Beach, and the division led the armoured thrust to retake Caen, which was heavily fortified and defended by the German Tiger tanks. Having successfully captured Caen, after bloody fighting, the division pushed through Belgium, meeting stiff resistance and then into Holland in preparation for Operation Market Garden. Arnhem was the next major objective, and the 32nd Armoured Brigade, comprising of the 2nd and 3rd Battalions of the Irish Guards and the 1st Battalion of the Welsh Guards, were ordered to seize the home bank of the River Rhine in preparation for the assault by the 1st UK Airborne, 82nd US Airborne, and the Polish Airborne Divisions. Arnhem saw the loss of many Allied troops, and eventually the bridge was secured and the crossing points established across the River Rhine, and the Allies continued the advance into Germany. After the war, Tim joined the Liverpool Police and served as a constable until he retired at age 55. Captain Fitzgerald was active for many years with the TA and the Army Cadets in the Liverpool and Sefton areas, spending many a weekend at Old Car Training Camp, as well as many camps in the Isle of Man and Scotland. He was also a long-standing committee member of the Irish Guards Association in the north of England. Tim married Pat in 1958 and has five sons, two of whom are with him here today. Today, the Honorary Consul of France in Liverpool, on behalf of the President of the Republic of France and its peoples, presents you with the Ordre National de Légion d'Honneur in recognition and thanks for your part in liberating France and its peoples from Nazi occupation and swiftly bringing to a close the war in Europe.
Nous vous faisons. Murdoch Cross, 5th Battalion of the Liverpool Kings Regiment. Murdoch Cross was brought up in Dovecote in the 1930s and later moved to West Army, where he continues to live today. Prior to joining the Army, Bernie was an apprentice mechanic. In 1943, he volunteered to join the Army and was assigned to the 5th Battalion, the Liverpool Kings Regiment. In 1943, the 5th and 8th Kings, the Liverpool Irish, received a specialist training in Ayrshire in preparation for the planned invasion of France. They had been selected to form the nucleus of the 7th and 5th beach groups, which would have the objectives of maintaining beach organisation, securing positions, and providing defence against counterattack. As invasion neared, in mid-1944, the two battalions moved from their camps to ports in southern England and embarked aboard troop ships and landing ship tanks. Having been delayed, the invasion fleet proceeded to Normandy on the 5th of June. Both King's battalions landed on D-Day, the 6th of June, the 5th at Sword Beach and the 3rd with the 3rd British Infantry Division and the Liverpool Irish at Juneau and the 3rd Canadian Infantry Division. At Sword, as the 3rd Division moved inland, the 5th Kings attempted to neutralise hostile positions and snipers. Under fire, the beach groups collected the wounded, the dead, and located and marked minefields, attempting to maintain organisation and directed vehicles and troops inland. The 5th Kings operated with the beach groups for a further 6 weeks. After taking part in the D-Day landings, Bernie was placed in a number of different battalions as he advanced through France. After being injured in Belgium near the German border, he was airlifted back to England to recuperate. After his recuperation, Bernie returned to the Royal Army Service Corps and spent time in Egypt and Greece, after which he left the army, returning to Liverpool. In Liverpool, he secured employment in the Automatic Telephone and Electric Company, locally called the Automatic, later PESIC, where he worked until he retired. He has been married for over 60 years to Flo. He has four children, 8 grandchildren, and 4 great-grandchildren. Today, the Honorary Consul for France in Liverpool, on behalf of the President of the Republic of France and its peoples, presents you with the Ordre National de la Légion d'honneur in recognition and thanks for your part in liberating France and its peoples from Nazi occupation and swiftly bringing to a close the war in Europe. As the Allies made plans to invade occupied France in 1943, The Liverpool Irish were selected to form the nucleus of the 7th Beach Group. The group's objectives on an invasion beach were to maintain organisation, secure positions, and provide defence against enemy counter-attack. Extensive specialist training occurred in Ayrshire and other parts of Britain. On the 30th of May 1944, the Liverpool Irish moved from its camp in southern England to the port of Southampton, where the 8th embarked aboard troop ships in early June. Elements of the Liverpool Irish embarked aboard the Ulster Monarch, formerly a passenger ship on the Belfast-Liverpool line. After a delay of 24 hours, the invasion fleet proceeded to Normandy on the 5th of June. On the 6th of June 1944, Michael landed at Juno Beach with the 7th Beach Group and the 3rd Canadian Infantry Division. Two companies of the Liverpool Irish were assigned to the Mike Green and Mike Red areas at Graceful Mare to reinforce the Royal Winnipeg Rifles, who incurred significant casualties. After intense machine gun and mortar fire, the landing of A Company proceeded well. In B Company areas, the late arrival of the tanks exposed the landing infantry to heavy machine gun fire. While under fire, the beach group collected the wounded and the dead, located and marked minefields, attempted to main organisation, and directed vehicles and troops inland. On the 7th of June, a bomb released by a lone Luftwaffe pilot exploded amongst the anti-tank platoon, killing 15 and badly wounded 7. Michael was a member of that anti-tank platoon. Due to the heavy losses, the battalion had been engaged in protracted operations for weeks. The battalion was put into a suspended ammunition in August 1944. Michael was assigned to the 1st Battalion of the Royal Ulster Rifles. After fighting through Belgium and Holland and into Germany, the battalion was then sent to Palestine. After the war, Michael returned to Liverpool in 1946 and worked as a scaler in the Liverpool docks. Thereafter, he took an apprenticeship in joinery and moved into the building trade, where he remained until his retirement. Today, the Honorary Consul of France in Liverpool, on behalf of the President of the Republic of France and its peoples, presents you with the Ordre National de la Légion d'honneur in recognition and thanks for your part in the liberation of France and its peoples from Nazi occupation and bringing swiftly to a close the war in Europe. And also, ladies and gentlemen, the Lord Mayor will also present Private Crumby with his Honorary Citizen of the City of Liverpool as well. Congratulations. recipient in the honour this afternoon is Rifleman Desmond James Ryan, 2nd Battalion of the Royal Ulster Rifles. Desmond was born in Liverpool in 1926. He grew up in the area of Vauxhall known as Over the Bridge and the Miriam Road in Anfield near Liverpool Football Ground. Growing up in this area was quite difficult for Desmond, was a staunch veteran. During the Second World War, Desmond, as a young teenager, volunteered for the Home Guard before enlisting into the 2nd Battalion of the Royal Ulster Rifles as a rifleman in 1944. The battalion, part of the 3rd Infantry Division, landed at Sword Beach on the 6th of June 1944 and fought in the Battle of Normandy, specifically in Operation Charnwood. On D-Day, the 6th of June, Caen was an objective for the 3rd British Infantry Division and maintained the focal point for a series of battles throughout June, July, and into August. The battle did not go as planned for the Allies, instead dragging on for 2 months because the German forces devoted most of its reserve to holding Caen, particularly their armoured divisions. As a result, German forces facing the American invasion thrust further west were spread thin, relying on the rough terrain of the backcountry to slow down the American advance of the Operation Cobra. With so many German divisions held up defending Caen, the American forces were eventually able to break through to the south and east, threatening to encircle the German forces in Normandy from behind. The 2nd Battalion, the Royal Ulster Rifles, were the first British troops to enter the city of Caen, which had previously seen bitter fighting with the British attempts to capture it. He served in France, Belgium, and Germany from 1944 until the end of the war, with responsibilities concerned with logistics and supplying ammunition to the front. At one point, with just 5 other soldiers, he oversaw a camp of 600 displaced persons, mainly Russians. He continued to serve in Palestine until he was discharged from the army in 1948. Post-war, he married the prettiest girl in Liverpool, Helen, and they had 2 daughters and 4 grandchildren. He worked as a maintenance engineer in the Liverpool warehousing and for the Ford Motor Company, with several jobs in between, including installing the heating and the engineering in the Metropolitan Cathedral of Christ the King, and delivering altar wine priests and monasteries all over the country. He spends his time with his family and following the adventures of the mighty blues. Today, the Honorary Consul for France in Liverpool, on behalf of the President of the Republic of France and its peoples, presents you with the Ordre National de la Légion d'Honneur in recognition and thanks for your part in liberating France and its peoples from Nazi occupation, swiftly bringing to a close the war in Europe. Stanley Hughes, Royal Regiment of Artillery. Richard was born on the 29th of July 1924 in Wrexham. In 1929, at the age of 5 years, the family moved to Liverpool after his father was injured whilst working in the slate factory in Wrexham. At the age of 18, Richard enlisted into the army, joined the 65th Medium Regiment of Royal Artillery in December 1942. He conducted basic training in Northern Ireland and thereafter trained as a driver and radio operator at Bamber Bridge in Lancashire. On the 6th of June 1944, he completed their final exercises at Kellybrae in Lincolnshire with his regiment in preparation for D-Day. On the morning of the 6th, Richard landed at Sawbeach on a tank landing craft driving a Bren machine gun carrier. Sawbeach was under heavy machine gun fire and artillery fire from the German forces. Sawbeach near Quon was the landing stage for the 3rd Infantry Division. Not long after advancing towards Quon, the division was attacked by the 21st Panzer Division, which inflicted heavy casualties. After the Allied breakout of Sawbeach, Richard fought through France, Belgium, and Holland to Nijmegen. He was wounded during Operation Market Garden, which was between the 17th and 25th of September 1944. After being evacuated, he returned to service in Germany in March 1945. He was in Hamburg on the day that the German High Command surrendered to the British forces on the Nuremberg Heath, south of Hamburg. Richard remained in Hamburg when war in Europe ended and served in the Army of Occupation until September 1946. After discharge, he completed a heating and ventilation engineering apprenticeship in 1948. Career highlights: chief engineer at Martin's Bank, Liverpool, and the senior clerk at works at Lancashire. Opposing them was the full strength of Luftwaffe No. 3, the RAF, the Luftwaffe command that had been based in France since 1914 and comprised of a large number of day and night fighters and medium bomber units. Stephen's role was to ensure that as many aircraft as possible were fit to fly, to support the Allied advance across Belgium, to secure the crossings in Arnhem, and eventually the assault over the river. In 1946, Stephen was demobbed and returned to Liverpool. He returned to the Automatic Telephone Company. Later, he worked in warehousing role for Nestle, and thereafter with Ben Ross Trading Company for 20 years until he took retirement. A keen musician, he played the drums in his own band, the VCs. He was married to Teresa, who sadly died at a young age. They had two children, Maureen. On his 90th birthday, Stephen did a tandem parachute jump in aid of the Order Hay Children's Charity Hospital, raising £2,500. Stephen returned to Normandy with other World War II veterans to remember those who fell on a foreign field during their duty. Today, the Honorary Consul for France in Liverpool, on behalf of the President of the Republic of France and its people,
presents you with the Order National de la Légion d'Honneur in recognition and thanks for your part in liberating France and its people from Nazi occupation and swiftly bringing to a close the war in Europe. Safe journey home.